Hi, I just wanted to do a quick video about how I feel about the new doctor, Jodie Whittaker. There's a lot of back and forth going on between fans, new and old. And I really feel like, for me personally, I think this is going to be sort of the same situation that happened with me with The Force Awakens. You know, I've always loved Star Wars ever since I was a kid. And, of course, I had big brothers who have, you know, passed that love on to me. I was too young, actually not born, and then too young to see the films in the theaters. So, but we were always one of the first families to get all the VHS tapes when they came out on video. God, I feel old. So, of course, I watched them as a child and growing up. But I feel like when the prequels came out, it wasn't that I lost any love for Star Wars at all. I think it was just that they didn't live up to what we all came to expect of Star Wars. I think that, of course, there were awesome things about the prequels, like Darth Maul being one example. But then, of course, we also, to offset the awesome, we had things like Jar Jar Binks, which, of course, some would, you know, argue was actually a brilliant Sith Lord. But when The Force Awakens came out, it was like I was a child again. That excitement and I just couldn't wait to see it again after I saw it the first. I couldn't wait to see it, and then I couldn't wait to see it again. I ended up seeing it 8 times in the theaters. It renewed that childlike excitement in me, that just, it was wonderful. And then, of course, Rogue One came out, which I didn't get to see in the theater. I moved to California. As you can see, my background is much different than it used to be. My old basement that I used to record in now is sunny California. So I didn't get to see it because I don't have a car out here yet. And I wasn't prepared to see it after that because of Carrie Fisher's death. And I still wasn't prepared once I actually saw it. But that's beside the point. So I feel like with Doctor Who, the same sort of thing happened with the last few seasons. I wasn't really super into the last two seasons, and I didn't even bother catching up. Of course, I've been doing a lot of voiceover work, and I have a lot of things going on with voiceovers out here. I've been extremely lucky to be working on Star Wars, Knights of the Old Republic, and things like that. So I've been very busy with that. So it's not an excuse, but it's kind of like I'm not really putting in an effort to see those seasons or catch up on them. But I feel like this new direction that Doctor Who is going in, and that's not to say because they hired a woman to be the doctor, it's just, it's different. It's going to be different writing, it's going to be different creativity, it's going to be different stories, and I feel like they're going in a different direction, and I think that's going to be great. I mean, I hope it is. I personally am going to give it a shot. And, you know, I've seen a lot of people saying things about, you know, well, the Doctor was a Time Lord, and the Time Lord can't be a woman, and it's Lord, not Lady. But Lord is actually not a title specific to women. The Queen is holds the title Lord of Man. So it's not specifically a male title. And I think Sith Lord is another good example of that. You know, when a female becomes a Sith Lord, she's not a Sith Lordess or a Sith Lady, she's a Sith Lord. So if you're a Lord of the Sith or a Time Lord, you know, it doesn't matter if you're a man or a woman. Also, you know, the Doctor's Gallifreyan, and Time Lord is a title. It's not male or female. So I wish people could get past that. And I think that a lot of people that are involved in the show, in the series, and a lot of people that are even involved in Big Finish, I know a couple of people I'm friends with on Facebook, and they're all really excited about this. And I trust their opinion. Above all, I trust their judgment on the direction that the series is going in. So I think that I'm going to look forward to it, you know. And I hope this renews my hope, I mean, or renews my love of the series. Not that I ever lost it. I still went to Gallifrey every year, and I still collect my Doctor Who collectibles and my pops and everything. I feel like I kind of fell out of that for a little while. So hopefully this is something that's going to bring it back full force, and I will have that childlike excitement again. But I hope, you know, we can all just agree to disagree, or, you know, or maybe some people come along and end up enjoying it. I know that a lot of older fans, there's kind of a division on it. You know, some are really excited and some are really, really angry about it. But hopefully this is something that that goes in a direction that we can all agree is going to be great, or, like I said, agree to disagree, and hopefully people still love their, you know, their classic Doctor Who, which I'm sure they will, because you can't not love classic Doctor Who, even if the effects weren't what they are today. But I hope we can all just still be one happy Doctor Who family, like it feels at Gallifrey One. And I actually am really looking forward to seeing a lot of new cosplay for Jodie Whittaker's Doctor. And I think I'm looking at it in a positive light, and I hope other people will too. Because Doctor Who has always been wonderful, and hopefully it always will be. I mean, I foresee it being wonderful until, you know, Cthulhu forbid, someday it's not on anymore. So that's just, you know, just a 6 minutes of my silly thoughts, and I thought I'd just put it out there. So I'll see you guys next time. Thanks for listening.